Welcome back. Well, Dr. Mohammad Choucair joins us again today with some interesting information from Archer. I tell you what, you're a busy man. ASX announcement again. We've been talking about quantum, not quantum leaps. What is quantum?
So at Archer, we're building our 1-2-CQ quantum processor chip, our room temperature quantum processor chip. And a quantum processor is essentially the core device or component in a quantum computer.
Computing's changed so much over the years. I mean, we've had all these computers. We have them at home. We don't realize what's in them. Most people at home, we go, you know, we just want to look at Google or watch a movie on Netflix. But for people at the top end of town that speak a language that you do, just explain something that you might say to a group of technical guys.
So quantum computing, you know, basically represents the next generation of powerful computing.
Yep.
It has the potential to really revolutionize the way that we transact as human beings and transact in the most fundamental forms, for example, in communication and financially.
Yeah, it's funny. I've run server rooms before working in media, and they're very interesting areas. People go, what are they like? I said, they're pretty cold, they're freezing. But this whole idea of running servers and all these wonderful applications now without all the add-ons is where it's all going. Quantum is so different because it's microscopic. The eye can't see it, can it?
So you've raised a really good point here in that you really do need the infrastructure and the resources in order to do this kind of computing.
Yeah.
At Archer, we're building the core device of a quantum computer, which, if we're successful, has the potential to allow the widespread use of quantum computing power technology. And just recently, what we've done is we've expanded strategically on our access to resources, infrastructure, and world-renowned experts in order to do the quantum in quantum computing.
It's another world. So people at IBM and all these big companies that are watching us today, what does it mean for their teams?
So right now, what I could say from a technical perspective is that we're in the stage, our second stage of development, which involves quantum measurements.
Mm-hmm.
Now, these kinds of measurements are not routine.
No.
And so the specific aspect of quantum measurements that we're focusing on now require the control over a single qubit component.
Mm-hmm. Which is another language. So a qubit component is?
So it's important to remember that the value right now in quantum computing around the world, primarily in Australia, the EU and the US, is derived from technical development.
Yep.
It's simply because quantum computers are not in everyday households at the moment.
No.
So they're still currently under development.
Sure.
And so the more and more we're able to technically develop our processor, the more and more likely we are to add value.
Well, when you think about it, this is endless where it goes into, doesn't it?
I mean,
the medical fields, airlines, aircrafts, shipping. I mean, we all use computers everywhere, schools.
So again, that's very important because materials are the tangible physical basis of all technology.
Sure, sure.
And the materials that we're using to develop this chip, you know, and in computing in general, has the potential to impact all services dependent on computational power.
Mm. I mean, we look at a watch and we go, oh, you know, that's a watch, but you're talking about something we can't even see behind the screen. How do you develop something like that? I mean, it must take years to develop this stuff.
We started back in April, and this is when we commenced the 1-2-CQ technology project.
Yep.
And that was to build this, you know, world-first carbon-based qubit chip.
Sure.
And you're right, you absolutely need access to very, very specialized infrastructure, facilities, instrumentation, people. And fortunately for us, this is what we've been able to do over the past 12 months. And we've been able to do this quite successfully.
Mm. Okay, so the next thing is control. What happens in that area?
So it gets very technical very quickly with control.
Yeah.
Control is the first stage of the first layer of our processor, where we're trying to define what we call the physical qubit. There's a Google search
term. I'll look it up after this show. I'll look that up later. Yes, keep going.
So it's important for us to get this right because this forms the fundamental function, the basic function of the chip.
Sure. Now, for people watching today, investors, what's the big sell here that you want them to take away?
So we're on track.
Yep.
And these measurements are not done overnight. They do involve very complex physics, very complex measurement setups, and to do these experiments and measurements around the world, which form the basis of our technology. And we're doing that, and everything's going very well.
Well, I tell you what, you're making a global impact in a microscopic market. I don't know how you do it, but it's fascinating stuff that you're working on. Thank you for coming in today.
Thank you for having me.
Fantastic. There you go, Archer Materials Limited. They're listed on the ASX as AXE. Quantum, watch out for it.